Most important thing with Google Meet is, I would say, your meet policy. We already talked about that a little bit, but I would recommend that for all internal meetings, you stick with Google Meet. What that's going to do is it's going to allow everyone to make use of Google. If you haven't already started using the recording feature, is probably the best feature of Google Meet, because every time that you record a meeting, automatically going to place that meeting recording into your Google Drive. And so when you are creating a training, when you're, you know, creating something for your team that they may need to reference later, you're going to basically, you just click one button right inside a meet, or maybe you're recording a client meeting, and it's going to automatically record the meeting, and then at the end of the meeting or when everyone's left, it's going to drop that straight into your Google Drive. Now, that shows up in a Google Drive folder called Meet Recordings. Now, what I like to do here is, let's say I've recorded a training video, my team recorded it in a Google Meet, I've ended the meeting, it's dropped it into the meeting folder here. I can take the video file, I can right click on the video file, and then I can move that over to my training folder for my team. So the workflow there is, quite often, I'll be on a meet with the team, and I'll say, hey, you know what, there's something I'm really interested in showing you, this is important. Cool, someone hits the record button, bang, gets recorded. Then at the end of the meeting, someone can pick this up, right click, move, bang, into the training folder. This is a very efficient process, and it makes it very easy to create training rather than bothering with screen casting, screen recording tools, or taking, for example, like a Zoom recording, and you've got to like wait for it to process after the call, and you've got to remember to drag and drop it into Google Drive, and you've got to wait for it to upload, and like all those things. To me, that's just additional steps of friction to actually get the job done. And so this is my favorite way to create recordings now. Even better if someone else can be responsible for taking the recording and moving it into the folder. It also means that, for example, Red, who's on the call with us, who's our sales manager, he will record training sessions with his team, and then immediately, you know, when he has new team members join, they can just jump straight onto trainings that he's already recorded. It makes it really great. It's especially useful for me, being a visionary entrepreneur who's not, you know, really amazing at the detail-oriented side of things from time to time, or ever. So I'll just talk, the team record, and then, you know, like, if I'm talking too fast, the team can just go back and re-watch the recording of like, oh, okay, what did Pete say on that meeting when he was talking about that thing?
If you like this content, please hit subscribe and hit the bell notification so you can be notified when we go live or drop new content on the channel. Now, if you'd like to connect with us, hit us up on social media or join our free community group. All the links to that are right below this video. If you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and the technology ecosystem, you can join our free Genius Academy by transferring your billing across to itGenius. Or you can join a Workspace Basics Bootcamp. Now, if you're a business owner and you're interested in an audit on your technology stack or your Workspace account, or you're looking to do a project in the tech world, well, you can take advantage of our free consultation. And if you need help right now, then consider joining Concierge or taking up a quick fix with our team for professional support for your tech stack.